Later that year, Princess Henrietta Adelaide suddenly took ill and passed away. Prince Ferdinand was consumed with grief and could not bear to listen to music without his wife at his side. He summoned Raphael. "Raphael, it was my beloved wife's fervent wish that you come to Munich to enrich our lives with your music. You have accomplished this beyond our expectations. But now that she is gone, I would like to release you from your duties. Of course, you can stay until you find another position. Oh, thank you, Your Royal Highness. You are most generous. Serving you has been a great honor, but I long to return to Italy," said Raphael, and bowed reverently to the prince. "Then go back to your home, Raphael. We will always remember you." Raphael returned to Cremona and bought a house on the Piazza Roma near Antonio Stradivari. He played concerts throughout Europe, but whenever he was in Cremona, he always found time to visit Antonio. Their friendship blossomed, and they never tired of exchanging ideas about music and the violin. Not long after returning to Cremona, he married Carolina. Raphael's violin has been captivating people with its beauty for over 300 years. Whenever you hear one of Stradivari's instruments being played, you too become part of its history. Each of his violins is a gift to us all.